four races. This year, she showed a lamb for the first time. She leased a very spirited carry-out lamb, whom she named Evie, from Sunny Hill Farm. Alexandra sewed this navy jumper dress with her 4-H leader, Sue Kaiser, for the Levi presentation at the fair. She needle-felted a lamb on each pocket to add fun and a personal touch. Although she started sewing 3 years ago, this is her first real hermit. This jumper offered lots of new challenges. Alexandra learned to sew darts and a lining and to put an invisible zipper in. Alexandra plans to spend the rest of the day in search of wool for next year's project. Thank you, Alexandra. It's always important you listen to your wife. She says move back because I've got to take pictures. I move back and he's taking pictures. Second contestant, Maggie Kelfenberg, a seventh grader from Clarence Middle School. She decided to make yoga pants and a coordinating pink shirt to complement the pink band and the pants. Maggie did a 4-H public demonstration on different wool fabrics and learned that wool is a great fabric for the athletic apparel because it keeps you cool and wicks moisture away from your body. Maggie plays field hockey, basketball, and shows her grandmother's dog at the local county fair. And a coordinating blue shirt to complement the blue band on the pants. Show the blue band. Ella and her twin sister wanted to sew matching outfits this year. Ella works to use her outfit for dress occasions, while her sister wants to use it for athletic events. Ella enjoys spending time for concerts. Macy decided that she would make a split skirt in a festive Pendleton plaid and a long vest in a silver embroidered medium weight wool that she found in loads of fabrics. Matching the plaids was challenging, but she loved the results. She almost didn't have enough of the vest fabric, and this was her first time making button loops. Macy raided her mom's button jars for the perfect button. She plans on wearing this outfit to her concerts this holiday season. When not sewing, Macy wore a buffalo. She would first like to give special thanks to her 4-H Lucky Leaps group leader, Sue Kaiser, who was instrumental in her superb teaching for this project. The use of her home equipment, and especially for upwards of 25 to 30 hours guiding Laura May in the art of sewing that it took her to make this beautiful wool skirt. She would also like to send heartfelt thank you to Sharon Shai. It features brass zippers on the pocket and the front. The shoulder tabs have brass buttons. For added embellishment. The dress is sleeveless with a fitted bodice and gored panels. She added a horsehair braid to the hem to add another flair. Anna shows steers, sheep, and horses at her local 4-H County Fair. She spends a lot of time giving educational tour on her family's agritourism farm. Great job, Anna. Well pockets and two-piece sleeves with insets. Her semi-fitted pants are made from the same pattern out of a gray wool gabardine. The pants also have pockets. Her red shirt is made out of light wool chalet and with blue polka dots to tie everything together. The shirt is fitted with a high waistline and Teflon accent. This is Hallie's favorite part of the outfit. Thank you, Hallie. She enjoyed sewing with wool so much in 4-H, she still does it in her adult years. The pink jacket is fitted with a princess seam and lined with polo fleece for warmth. The zipper gives it a sporty feel. The wrap skirt is flared with a center waist. It features the ends of D-ring and is lined with polo fleece. Lynette knew she wanted. My phone got in the way. Lynette knew she wanted to. Do something unique. She was inspired to knit a worsted wool sweater using a Marilyn Coleman pattern. That was a challenge and done over 4 months and many corrections. To add a finishing touch, Lynette used her own thin sheet wool to wet felt her hat. She bought her U in last year's festival here and proud of the result. I like her hand. I tried to pluck it, but she said, don't touch it.
It's on photo. It's got a lot of
100% red wool coat. After cutting the fabric pieces, Barbara noticed there was a mistake. A trip to the store ended in her decision to add black to her coat design. During this process, Barbara realized that mistakes can sow your imagination. She is very happy with the alterations she made on her red and black wool coat. In her classic herringbone Woolridge wool coat, she accented the coat with a leather collar. Yep, it's there. The coat is completely underlined for added warmth. The pattern is Berta, a favorite pattern company of hers. The wool was a gift from her husband last year. Her husband always gives her special and unique gifts, ranging from snow tires for Valentine's Day. Now, what are you laughing at? Do you like driving around without snow tires? Not in Canandaigua, you don't want to. And another gift was today for this show. But the shirt she had wanted to wear didn't have sleeves done. Yep, that's difficult. So she found another one of her projects, an Angora wool blend sweater that was knitted a few years ago. She loves the color and the comfy feeling. Megan's main purpose is to show that no matter what shape or form wool can look beautiful. And once that was done, we were off and running with the manufacturer of this shirt. The embellishments are done in penny wool style with a buttonhole stitching and embroidery to add detail. Sam recently discovered needle felting.
The night shirt he was last seen in is too short to be allowed at the New York State contest. So a compromise was made, and he is modeling a blue and green plaid Pendleton shirt that he likes to wear for the warmth and comfort. The plaids were tough to match, and the shirt has buttons on the correct side, which his daughter always gets wrong. However, she did get the cuffs backwards on this one. As a concession, Gary was allowed to carry a pillow that was made out of the fleece from his cordel sheep. He has found that it's really comfortable to sleep on, and he can't wait for his sheep to grow more fleece so he can have more pillows. We would like to thank Pam and Gary for all their help with the Make a Wool contest. Vest, this one is no exception. He has been asking his wife to make him a wool vest, and he loved the ones that the historical interpreters were wearing, so this is what she came up with. Thomas Jefferson's Southwest. Western style. Since she was working with a remnant, there wasn't a lot of room to match the pattern, but it came out pretty close, and it's reversible to boot.